Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to explain Introduction to Arrays concept. Variables we have been using so far like a, b, sum, num, n1 are called simple variables. So simple variables can be used to store one item of data. For example, int a equal to 5, b equal to 6, char variable ch equal to r. So these simple variables can store only one value, but sometimes there will be a situation in which we want to store a group of related items and we want to refer them by a common name. For example, suppose a class contains 70 students and we want to store their roll numbers. So we need how many variables? 70 variables, right? For example, int roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 3, and so on, roll number 70. For example, if we want to store 100 students, we need how many variables? 100. But it would be complex and time consuming to write code to manipulate these 70 variables. So think of how you would assign values to these 70 variables. And what if we need to deal with 500 students? The answer is simple. The best way is to use an array to store the 500 student roll numbers. So what is an array? An array is a special type of variable which represents a group of elements of same data type. It can store a group of elements. So we can store a group of int values or a group of float values in the array, but we cannot store some int values and some float values in the array. So what is an array? An array is a special type of variable which represents a group of elements of same data type. Types of arrays. Arrays are generally categorized in two parts. First one is single dimensional array, that is 1D, one dimensional. And next one is multi-dimensional arrays. Now I'll tell you array declaration. Before an array is used, you must declare. For example, we want to use roll number array in our program and we want to store integer values. So before roll number, here roll number is name of the array and 70 is size of the array, and int is a data type. It means we'll accept integer values. So this declares that roll number is an integer array or an array of ints with subscripts ranging from 0 to 69. Here subscript means index. Roll number of 0 means first element. We'll store first element. So roll number 1 means second element, index is here 1. So what is the last element index? Here index is 69. So last element we can store. Now I'll tell you array declaration. Here roll number is name of the array, 70 is size of the array, So here I'm writing array name is roll number and first element. For example, I'll store 11. So what is the address of 11? That is 0. Index is here 0. That is roll number of 0. So in roll number of 0 we can store first element. So here first element is 11. And what is the address of second element? That is roll number of 1. Like that. What is the address of last element? Here how many elements we are trying to store here? Total 70. So roll number of 70, right? Total element 70. 70 minus 1, 69. So address is 69. Here index is 69. Because roll number 0 to 69, total 70 elements. Initializing arrays. You can initialize an array in C either one by one or using a single statement as follows. You can see here mark. Mark is the name of the array. Int is a data type and 6 means size of the array. Here array name is mark. So up to 6 elements we can store. Now you can see this program inserting elements into array and display elements. First two header files. Hash include, we are including std standard, I means input, O means output, H means header file. So we are including cyanio.h, console input output, these two are header files. And whatever we write, we'll write inside main function. So void main, open bracket, close bracket. Whatever we write within main function we'll write. And now you can see int n of 10. N is name of the array and 10 is size of the array and data type is int. And next int I comma j. I and j are simple variables. CLR SCR means clear screen. So previous output will be deleted. And next we are using for loop. And right side also you can see another for loop. First for loop is for storing elements. And here I equal to 0. We are checking condition 0 less than 10. Yes, condition is true. So in n of I, we can insert first element that is 11, I value 0, that is index is 0, right? And next I plus plus, I value equal to 1, so index is 1. So in this we can enter second element by using scanf. And next I plus plus, index is 2, I equal to 2, so we can enter 13 value. And next index is 3, that is I value is 3, so value is 14. Next index I value is 4, and next 5 6 7. So we are entering elements. So last index is 9. So starting is 0, index is 0, ending is 9. So total 0 to 9, 10 elements we can enter. For example, I want to display 15, right? So we can use n of 4 because 15, element 15 address is 4. You can see how we'll represent in array. Yes, 11, index is 0, 11 is first position, address is 0, element 12, index is 1, and last element also you can see, that is 20 element, index is 9, and see, if we want to display element 19, what is the address? N of 8. right? N of 8 means 19. So this for loop is for storing elements, and next, yes, this for loop is for displaying elements. For j equal to 0, 0 less than 10, yes, condition is true, so it will enter inside for loop. Printf, index of j value is 0, so index of 0 equal to, what is the index of 0 value? 11. And next, j plus plus, so 1. Index of 1 value is 12. Two less than 10, yes, condition true, so index of 2 value 13. So like that, j value will increment up to 9, so index 9 value is 20. So we can display 11 to 20 numbers by using index.
Yes, same program I explained, you can see output here. Yes, this for loop is for storing elements, and this for loop is for displaying elements, and we are here we used ampersand address, right? And here we are not using ampersand, we are not inserting element. Now you can see output. Yes, enter 0 element 11. Enter first element 12, next 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now you'll get output like this. Index of 0, 11. Index of 1, 12. Up to 9.